this led me to actually have a lot more time because I wasn't trying to push something. Today, my winners, we're going to talk about expectations. Expectations is the thing that really messes us up. It's not your plans that went to shit. It's not what he did or she said or any of it. It's actually our expectations every time. This is a little bit hard to understand until you really see how many expectations you have during just one day. Small ones, big ones, expectations from other people, expectations from yourself, expectations from objects and everything around that. We expect so many things every day. And so today we're talking about expectations, and I'm going to tell you how I solved that problem. I am a person that has no chill, absolutely no chill regarding the time in my day. I am constantly doing something. I don't have that time in the evening where I sit down and just scroll through Netflix or anything. That time doesn't exist. I get up at 4:44 in the morning, and then I'm all rock and roll until I go to bed at around 10 p.m. Sometimes earlier because I fall dead in my bed, but still. Why I'm telling you this is because I had a lot of expectations because I make a lot of plans, I have a lot of goals, and I have many projects. So expectations were a very big part of my reality because I believed that I needed to expect certain things from myself and from certain people to be able to make the plans and have the goals. But what I realized was that expectations has absolutely nothing to do with those things. And that might sound absolutely logical to you now, but that wasn't for me. So when I had a kid about a year and a half ago, that of course changed my whole life, obviously. It also changed my whole day, how I was operating, how I was working and all the projects I'm running and everything. I had to find a way that I don't get disappointed all the time because I was having expectations. Someone said that expectations are premeditated resentments, and I really love that quote. I can't remember who said it, but listen to that. Just listen to it. Expectations are premeditated resentments. That is exactly what it is. So when you expect things, of course it's not going to turn out the way you expect it to. Sometimes it might, mostly it won't. Say that quote out loud to yourself and realize the meaning in it because it's so powerful. When have you experienced that your expectations are something good? When? Never. You have to realize that expectations are not the same things as goals. And I know that a lot of people who are into law of attraction and visualization and everything think that expectations are the same thing. It's not. It's not the same thing at all. So expecting something to happen the way you want it to happen will only bring you resentment and disappointment. So when we go about our day expecting things to turn out the way we want to, pretty fast you'll realize that whenever your plans start going downhill in the morning, the rest of the day just follows. Have you had, of course you have, had such a day when you have the best plan ever the day before, then you go to bed as soon as, what is this? And as soon as the alarm sets off, you experience problems right there and then. Maybe you have a headache, maybe you have slept terribly and you can't get up when the alarm goes off. So just imagine this very typical day when you have the perfect plan the day before. You know where you're going, when you're going to get up, you know exactly what you're going to do, you know exactly what you are expecting for the day to happen, and you have this big planning and you're all inspired and motivated and everything. And then the morning comes, the alarm goes off. You're tired as hell because you slept terribly. Maybe you have a big headache. And this is the moment when it all starts to go to shit. And it's not if of course it's not because you decided for it to go to shit, but this is the moment when all your expectations just set off and you compare every minute of that day and every minute of that process with what you expected. And now because you're stressed, maybe you spill coffee all over your shirt or something else happens. It's a traffic jam. Of course, it's a traffic jam, right? And then you get to work, you're about to present a project and your coworker fucked something up or something is late and you get even more stressed and everything just seems to be chaos. The thing is, nothing is chaos. Nothing actually really happened. Nothing changed. It's just that you are comparing every minute of that day to your expectations that you set out for yourself the day before. This is what happens when we set out the New Year's goals, or you know, when we say to ourselves, on Monday I'm going to eat better and start working out and this and that. And then Monday comes and this is the kind of Monday you get. Are you going to make the changes you said yesterday? Of course you're not, because now you're just angry. And you are resentful and you are disappointed and everything seems to go against you. So why are expectations resentments? Because obviously it's not going to go according to your plan. The world doesn't care about your plans. The world doesn't care about your expectations. As long as you have these expectations, you are going to be disappointed. You are going to feel resentful every time. And the longer you hold on to these expectations, the more resentful you will be. Now let's take this and look at relationships. What do you expect from your relationships with your partner, with your mother and father, and with your friends, with your children? What are your expectations there? Because probably no one will ever meet them. No one will ever be able to meet your expectations and you will be resentful. Are you expecting certain things when you come home from work? Are you expecting things from the people around you, the people you love, from your family, that they don't even know about? We have so many expectations that we think are perfectly logical. So, for example, I'm here with my daughter. She's running around here playing. I'm doing this video. And I am expecting for her to just drink her smoothie and have a pretty nice time walking around here. But at any second, she can just decide that that's not what she wants to do anymore, and she wants all of my attention, and I have to stop doing what I'm doing. This is the way I worked on my expectations and became really, really aware of this. We have expectations that we are not even aware of. So imagine that. You're not aware of your own expectations, but you still have them on your relationships and on yourself and on the day. And when they are not met, you are mad and resentful, irritated, disappointed, and all of these negative feelings, and you don't know why. You just feel bad and you don't know why. The people around you can see that you're hurting and they don't know why, and you expect them to know why, but you really don't know why. We really want people to be mind readers, but we always forget that we see differently. Every one of us sees the situations differently. So the way that I really had to confront all my expectations was when my daughter just came to the world, and I, a very busy person who does all these things all day, of course I knew that I had to change all of my plans, like forever, of course. As she was growing and week by week, we had set these routines that still gave me some time to do the things that I usually do, like work and work out and everything. So coming from a reality where I worked out at least 1 hour every day and I've been working the whole day, to not knowing how my day would be like, to then having some sort of routine, and she was sleeping a lot because of course small babies sleep a lot, I started to set these routines and I could begin to expect when she was about to sleep, when she was about to wake up, and all of these things. So again, expectations were arising. And then for a month I could do a lot of things. But then a month went by and I had this routine. So she started to change her routines. So I really started to get irritated because now I had expectations that I didn't even know about, but I have built them around this new routine. And so we set a new routine, and then that was holding up for like 2 or 3 weeks. I was happy again. And then she started to change everything because she's a growing child. I couldn't do anything anymore because I didn't know what to expect. And I needed to expect something. So this is where I really started to work with all these expectations. I just sat my butt down and identified everything that I was expecting from my day. That list was a lot longer than I want to admit. That made me really see, because I wrote it down. Whenever you write down something, you manifest it. You give it real life, because now you can visually see it. And I could see that I expected a lot of things. And I also deep dove into how I expected these things to unfold. So where I wrote down that I expected myself to be able to work out. And I started an experiment on myself. So that experiment was basically that I would start my day with absolutely no expectations. I would be like water, just do what I can, when I can. And that felt, well, of course, really scary because I'm a very goal-oriented person. I want results from my day. I need to be better today than I was yesterday. And that's also a definition, but for me, that means in all the areas where I have goals, I need to feel that I'm progressing at least 1% every day. So now when I started doing this no expectations thing, that made me just, you know, fly around like a ghost in my days. But this is, I gave myself 2 weeks to find out what happens if I do it like this. The day would start as usual, and I would recognize where we had routines and where we didn't. And then when she fell asleep and I could do something that I usually do. So her first nap, for example, I would go and try to work out. And I know that that wasn't happening because she wouldn't sleep as long, or she would wake up when she realizes that I'm not there. It's about adapting. So what I did was, whenever she took her first nap during the day, I would start working out. I could just do my workout for 7 to 9 minutes before she woke up and she realized that I wasn't there. This is usually where I became very disappointed because I couldn't work out. So what happened was, I would do the 7 to 9 minutes, and when she woke up, I would just go there. The next nap, what do we have again? We have a break, a moment, a chance to keep working out. So then I went back, did that. Maybe this time I had 15 minutes. And the next time I also had 15 minutes or 7 minutes. So that's what I did. In the beginning, I was working out 5 times a day. So I started doing this with everything. I would start my day like water, like a ghost. No expectations, just doing what I can when I can. This led me to actually have a lot more time because I wasn't trying to push something that wasn't happening. And this turned out to work perfectly, because then after a month, again, she would change her routine. And again, I would be without structure, without routines, not knowing when I can do what and everything. But because I had no expectations, the biggest thing was just the realization of how many expectations I had. Whenever I feel some kind of resentment or disappointment, I know that no matter who did what, the reason I'm disappointed is because I had a different expectation. You really need to live your life without expectations, because these are the ones that are making you miserable. If you are generally unhappy in your life, then you probably have some hidden expectations you're not aware of yet. Be aware of them. You need to get aware of everything that you're expecting. Maybe you just expected to be happier. Yes, why? What did you expect to happen? Because whenever we feel some sort of resentment, we wanted something to be different. Be aware of this. And then you can choose. You can choose what you want instead. But if you don't know what it is that you want instead, then you will always be trapped in this unhappy, resentful, disappointed cloud of feelings. That's that. Please ask me questions about this. This is a little tougher area to pinpoint and to know how to start working on. I would suggest that every time you feel some kind of negative emotion, track that back to what was I expecting in the first place? What was I expecting instead? What is it that I want instead? That is what I would tell you or ask you if you sat in my chair and I was coaching you, I would ask you this. So remember, expectations lead to resentment. Expectations lead to disappointment. And most probably you are disappointing yourself. No matter what anyone does to you, it doesn't matter really, because you need to see what you expected from them and what you expect from your life. And then you can just choose and you can set boundaries and you can form your life in the way you want to. This is a very interesting inner work. So for all of you that like to work on yourselves and develop yourselves and get to the next level of you, this is a really interesting challenge, and you will find out so many things about yourself. So I hope to see you next week, because now I'm posting Mondays. If you are not subscribing, please do that. If you are liking this video, please do that. Comment, I would love to hear from you, and you will also give me lots of ideas for next week's topic. Thank you so much for hanging out with me. Stay classy, people, and I will see you next week. Bye.